Hey guys, this is Camford15. I'm back at it with another video for you guys, and I'm back with some more quintessential quintuplets reviews. Like I've said for the last, I guess, few videos I made this week, I'm issuing myself an apology. If you guys check out my quintessential quintuplets content and you are not subscribed to the channel, the reason why there was no quintessential quintuplets review last week for episode 7 was because I actually got my lower wisdom teeth taken out last week on Wednesday, and I definitely could not talk, on Thursday of last week. But here I'm back in what I thought was a pretty good episode. Again, I really enjoyed last week's episode. Like, it was freaking hilarious. The balls on Nino to do what she did. I did have a whole week in review, which I'm going to put at the end of my outro. So if you want to get my thoughts of Quintessential Quintuplets episode 7, you can go check out that video. And I've actually put it in a timestamp where you can go to that and get my thoughts. But this week, it kind of focuses on Futaro trying to learn the sisters better. This episode was kind of a mixture of a little bit featured of main feature of Ichika and Miku, which, you know, the whole episode was them going on a trip as well as still figuring out who is the mysterious Itsuki. And the whole concept of this episode is essentially Futaro trying to realize or trying to tell which, you know, sister is which this episode. That was kind of the Miku side plot, you know, the thing. And the thing was the fact that, you know, honestly, now looking at it, it's probably gonna be a short review. Thing is, you know, we know Futaro, he can't tell each of the sisters apart when they look alike. And funny enough, the episode starts off with them going in their rooms, them all dressed as Ichika, because we find out that the reason why they all dress the same is because their grandfather essentially prefers it that way, because since they all grew up as kids looking alike, he'd be used to them looking alike and stuff like that. So, I guess you can say it's his preference, they look all look similar. And it's funny too, because he's like, he can tell each of them differently by who they are. And it's funny because he tells Futaro, like, yeah, you'll be able to tell them apart by the mannerisms, the way they talk, the way they act, yada, 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 which again, you know, furthers the point, which I think us at the audience have told Futaro, like, bro, it's easy to tell which one is which, and stuff like that. Now, the whole Miku thing kind of comes in because she's kind of disappointed at the fact that Futaro can't tell, you know, which sister is which. And we know that Miku really does like Futaro along with two other sisters, of the fact that, hey, you know, listen, you know, I'm just disappointed that he can't tell me or he can't explain who it is. And then the end of the episode, which was a very sweet moment, you know, they have a talk where she's dressed up as Itsuki again, and he's trying to guess who it was. He gets it almost right, and essentially, he thinks that Miku was Ichika, and instead of Miku essentially, you know, realizing that, oh, you know, you're lying, you're wrong, she kind of sucks it up and she kind of lies saying she's Ichika. And she's like, haha, you fooled me, trying to pretend like she's Ichika. And she's walking away. She's obviously very much upset and crying and emotional. And Futaro picks this up. He sees not only the way she kind of walks, because he was earlier in the episode, he was kind of looking, honestly, at her ass, to be honest. And the way her butt was moving was the same way he saw her the first time. But then the thing that kind of gave it a dead giveaway that it was Miku was the fact that he saw her fists obviously like clenched up and shaking, because she was obviously mad and upset and sad. And then he's like, wait, you're Miku. And then you'd think Miku would lash out at him and say, like, how it took you this long to figure out and stuff like that. And you'd think she'd storm off, but no. She's just happy that Futaro could tell that was her, and you get a very nice freaking scene. Now the thing is too, she also reveals to Itsuki, which I believe this is the first time Itsuki knows, that, what's her face likes, Futaro. And Itsuki is shocked at this. But the reason why she's like, I guess you can say afraid, is because we find out it was Miku that was the girl from last week that essentially pressed Futaro downstairs to the little log cabin. We find out the reason why she kind of says she wants this whole relationship to end. What she wasn't meaning, like their whole relationship thing to end, what she meant was she wanted their student-teacher relationship to end because she sees him as his teacher, and obviously to her, you know, Futaro sees her as a student, which I guess I can understand where she's coming from. And she kind of wants to change that. But at the end of the episode, you know, it looks like it's going to be a part where Miku tells or maybe confesses that she herself also does like Futaro, but she kind of doesn't say it, and she kind of cock blocks Futaro from telling him because she kind of is like, well, I guess we can keep this relationship going. We are student and teacher, which I'm like, dog, just say you like him. I'm like, see, again, props to Nino because she broke the trope last week of girls hiding their feelings for a guy they like. Miku continues the trope of a girl not telling. And the Ichika storyline revolves around Ichika essentially, again, having doubts within herself, which we've seen this season, or earlier on in the season, which I believe was episode 5. And essentially, we have a, you know, bath scene with Nino and Ichika. And essentially, Nino's essentially telling Ichika, like, what should I do if I like this guy and stuff like that. And essentially, Ichika's like, well, I don't know if it's the best thing. And the funny thing is, we find out, because Ichika actually asked the question, because we know that she likes Futaro too. And she's like, well, what would happen if some other girl liked him? And essentially, you get flat out confirmation that Nino's like, oh, well, yeah, that would suck. But regardless, I'm going to win his heart first without specifying who it was. And stuff like that, which is very interesting from Nino's perspective, essentially saying like, okay, yeah, if there's another girl that's out there that likes him, fine, I'm just gonna beat them to the punch, I'm gonna run them over, essentially. And you know, you have this nice talk between Ichika and Yotsuba, because we know that Ichika, she's hiding her feelings in, and she can't keep her feelings. She knows she wants Futaro and she wants to tell him, but you know, she doesn't have the guts to do it. And this is even when Yotsuba's like, listen, I just want you to kind of be yourself, like be who you want to be and stuff like that. So, you know, we find out the reason why Ichika kind of took the more assertive role of being more mature and being the more bigger, older sister, which she is because after their mother passed away, obviously had Itsuki very much emotional. And that's when she took the next step to be like, I gotta grow up and I gotta mature and be a good sister and stuff like that. Again, it was a whole nice little thing going on there. It was funny. A funny episode. A very nice, sweet episode. I really did like the ending. That was an emotional moment. I am a Miku fan as much as she's probably my third favorite sister. But these people, I swear, man. This show really does make you like, oh, I really loved Nina last week. Now they're making me really love Miku. And then it's like, come on, Ichika too? I'm like, oh, brother. We got 3 sisters that are all in love with Futaro. The other 2, I don't know if they have yet to develop their feelings for Futaro unless they get more development and more focus on them. They've shown much of nothing, no affection for Futaro. I guess you can say kind of this episode kind of confirmed that Itsuki kind of doesn't see Futaro as a love interest. Now, who knows if that could happen later on in the show. But, you know, who knows. Other than the episode was good. Obviously, I think I would say my most funny parts of the episode was when he's trying to beg their grandfather, please teach me your ways, Futaro, to identify one. And then I like the scene where he's trying to hide under their little futon and he's trying to find out, okay, one of them would have a bruise. Whoever I bumped into, and he's literally looking up their freaking kimonos. I'm like, bro, really? Okay, you're wrong for that. But I'll say this: Nino had to like that, even though she was like, "What the hell are you doing?" That's the only thing I gotta say, which was funny. Which, again, this show is hilarious and wholesome. But next week, it seems by the title, they're gonna be going back to school again, and I'm guessing they're gonna be in class 3-1, maybe together. I don't know, but their summer break is gonna be ending next week, and I can't wait to see more wholesomeness. But anyways, guys, again, sorry for not getting this episode review, our last week episode review up because of that, and I'm sorry you guys didn't know. I actually did make a little short video explaining that I'd be taking a week off, but hey, Quintessential Quint episodes is back until the season ends, and yeah. I don't know how many episodes this season, is gonna have. I think it's gonna be 12 episodes this season has. So we're at episode 9, so we got 4 more episodes, I believe, and then we're done. 3 more episodes, I believe. Yeah, 9, 10, 11, no, 4. Okay, right. Yeah, we got 4 more episodes this season, but I really do hope we get a season 3, because I really do like this show. Otherwise, if we don't, I guess I'll read the manga, which apparently I heard is very controversial in terms of the ending. Do not spoil the ending in the comment section, please. Even though I think when I looked through the Verve comments, I think I saw somebody spoil the ending, which I'm like, fuck. But anyways, that's kind of it. So hopefully you guys have a great rest of your day. Until then, stay safe out there, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.